Welcome, Wizards and Warriors, to NOG Talk. Today, there are 11 changes to old cards and 5 brand new cards. But most importantly, there's a new mechanic coming to NOG. Stay tuned. Starting off, the kill pill is now going down to a lifespan of 2, so after 2 turns, the kill pill will kill whatever card it's on. Next up, the ice witch is gaining 2 HP and 1 damage to make it a little bit better. And then, the cauldron. Now, after using your free spell, you must wait 1 turn before doing it again. Compound F has been changed so that when you play it on a card, it sets it to 1 HP, but with the fly's ability. Then, after the 2 turns, you go back to whatever HP you had before you played it. Spell Mutation is becoming a permanent spell. When playing it, it now doubles the effect of anything that is already on it, so this Blazing Protection will now do 6 damage things that attack it, but now, any new spells placed afterwards will also take effect, so the Shrink Potion will do double its effect, quartering your HP, but timesing your damage by 4. Wick is getting a change where now he has to attack at least twice, otherwise he will not blow up. Minotaur and Cupid are getting their damage separated from their attacks. Cupid has not got any other changes. The Minotaur no longer does 2 times the amount of opposing cards, but instead 1 plus the amount of opposing cards. Here, if I was to attack, I do 1 damage plus 1, because they have 1 card, therefore I would do 2 damage to all opposing cards. In this case, just the Goblin Boxer. Now, when I use my attack, I hit all opposing cards, dealing 1 damage plus 1 for every opposing card. So I do 1, 2, 3, 4 damage to all of the cards. Jetpig has been reworked. His ability now is that he will hit all opposing cards, but if there is more than 1, then he will not hit the card with the lowest HP. In this scenario, because there is 1 card, he will hit it, dealing 4 damage. In this scenario, when he uses his attack, he'll hit all opposing cards, except for the one with the lowest HP. Cushion Blow is getting a rework, becoming a lifespan of 2 spell. You will play it on an enemy card, and choose one of your cards to take half of the damage straight away. In this scenario, 2 damage, and I'm going to choose the Frozen Rex. And in return for taking the damage, their card's next 2 attacks will do half the damage, no matter what it is. The last change to an old card is the Precision Scope, being remade into the Poison Scope. You play it on any card, and their attacks are guaranteed to hit whoever they attack, along with the ability that your turn after, you'll do an extra half of the damage to your target. The Poison Scope's first ability allows it so my Deputy Goblin will guarantee to hit the fly, ignoring the fact that I have to flip for it. The scope also lets me ignore trees, because anything I attack will guarantee to take the damage. Therefore, the Frog Lizard will die, even though we have a tree. The same goes for Bullseyes. If I have a Poison Scope, I'm allowed to ignore their Bullseye and attack whoever I want. The Poison aspect of this. If I was to attack this, I would deal 5 damage, but on my next turn, they would take an additional 2.5 damage, which is half of what I attacked. Due to it being poison, it means the Snake Goblin is immune to the poison effects, therefore it will not take the secondary damage on your next turn. Now for the 5 new cards coming to NOG. But stay tuned, because there's a new mechanic at the end of this video that you are not going to want to miss. The first new card is the Tub, with 8 HP, and its ability that you can use 1 turn to remove any spell card on deck, but the card that it is removed from will gain 1 HP and 1 damage, and after doing this you must wait 1 turn before doing it again. In this scenario, with the Tub, I can use up one of my turns to remove the Mousetrap, but the Apple Worm would gain 1 HP and 1 damage as a side effect. I could play a Poison on my own card, and in the same turn, remove it, where my Robofrog would gain 1 HP and 1 damage. The next card coming to the game is the 3 Bears, with 12 HP. The first time they attack, they do 1 damage, too small. The second time they attack, they do 7 damage, too big. And the third time they attack, they do 4 damage, just right. Taking turns, I would do 1 damage, I would take damage, and then I would do 7 damage, then I take damage, and then I do 4 damage. And afterwards, I would go back to 1 damage. However, if I attack, do 1 damage, attack again, do 7 damage, then I play Factory Reset, it'll make it so my next attack starts at the first one. So, if I attack again, I go back to 1 damage. The next card is Medusa, with 9 HP, 3 damage. And any card to attack Medusa turns to stone, where they cannot be used for 1 turn. Here, if it is my opponent's turn, they attack me, I take the damage, but their card turns to stone. So their next turn, they are not allowed to use it. Ambush, with a lifespan of 2, you'll play it on an enemy card, and at the end of your next turn, every single one of your cards will attack it, and only that card, without using an attacking turn. Playing it on the Log of Goblins, I would have to wait 1 turn, and then, at the end of my next turn, all 3 of these cards would attack only the Log of Goblins. Because it has a lifespan of 2, after playing it, it gives your opponent 1 turn to respond, whether they want to Factory Reset to completely remove the ambush, Spell Vaccine to make the ambush no longer work, or even move it. Moving an ambush onto your own cards will make them all attack your own card. Furthermore, the ambush counts as 1 attack, not 3 separate attacks, so the Champion Spirit would only activate once, not 3 separate times. The final card coming in this NOG update, before I reveal to you the new mechanic, is the magic chains. You'll play it on any card you want, and the next thing to affect that card will also affect their teammates, be it damage, HP, or spells. Simplest way to use it is to play magic chains on one of the enemy cards, and when you attack that card, you deal full damage to it, along with their teammates. So all three cards will take 4 damage, because I attacked. Although, you can damage the entire team, the magic chains is not limited to that. By playing magic chains, you can shrink the entire team, putting each one of them at half HP and double damage. Permanent spells like Champion Spirit, Fighting Spirit, Bees do not duplicate across teammates due to them not having an immediate effect. You can also pair cards like Factory Reset, which will reset every single one of your teammates, Ejector Seed, which will send out all of your teammates and bring them all back at the same turn. If we played it differently by playing the chains on the Log of Goblins and then swap the HP, the fly would get 20 HP, and the Log of Goblins would get 1, but because it's the chains, all of the other cards would be sent to 1 HP. The rule of thumb for the chains is that if it immediately affects the card, it will immediately affect all of the teammates. Now, the new mechanic coming to the game is charge attacks. Oh my god. Charge attacks. Whoa. To charge an attack, you use up one attack and go where you would have attacked, but instead you're moving that damage to your next go. If Zippy was to charge an attack, it would charge the attack, use up your attack and go, and the next turn, that 3 damage would be added, so the next time Zippy attacks, it'll do 6 damage, because it's the base damage plus the charged damage. Reversing the rolls here, if the dice wanted to charge an attack, you would roll the dice, get a 4, and that 4 damage would be carried over to his next attack, so when he attacks next, with a 5, the 4 would be added to make a 9 when it attacks. As a reminder, charging attack is moving whatever damage you would have done to the next time that you attack. And that is all for today's NOG Talk. Some huge, huge changes, and I hope you all enjoy.